We have a special surprise for your business segment this morning. Mike Eppel joins us now with his daughter, Jaden, and it is Take Your Kid to Work Day?
Yes. Well, a modified version because, of course, every day is Take Your Daughter, in this case, to Work Day because we're working from home. So how's it going this morning, Jaden?
Pretty good.
Yeah. Are you enjoying getting up early?
Yeah.
that's about right.
Did she have to wake up at 3:30, Mike?
No, I didn't put the that stringently, but nevertheless, I mean, honestly, they're always kind of walking through the home office, right? So it's not as if but having said that, the excitement of being live on television, that comes as one of the benefits of the job.
Absolutely.
What do you like best about my job, by the way?
I guess cool that you're on TV.
There you go. It is cool. It is cool to be on TV.
She's making her TV debut today. All right, Mike, let's
get right
into it. Jobs,
yes.
jobs. The Canadian economy regains over 83,000 jobs in October. That's good news, hey? Good news for this Friday?
It is. Yeah, feel good Friday, right? But I do have to put it into context. It's actually a bit of a come down from what we had seen in the previous months, simply because of the fact that, you know, some cities were back in lockdown last month. So we didn't see the momentum continue to build. And that's probably going to be the way it is right now. We just keep adapting as we go to the COVID-19 case counts. BC had jobs growth, Alberta, Ontario, those were your main contributors to the uptrend. The unemployment rate is now just back below 9%, still elevated, still a long way to go. In the United States, it's below 7%. They, you know, haven't been shutting things down, certainly not as much as they have here. And their job momentum has continued to the upside for the most part.
And of course, I got to ask you the other big business story this week. This week, a massive 4-day rally for Wall Street.
Yeah, 7% over 4 days for the Dow, 9% for the NASDAQ. And this morning, just quick check, and things are steady because we're trying to get the vote count out of Pennsylvania. Looks like that's siding toward the Biden camp, Mary. And what we are seeing in reaction to that is the cannabis companies, they're on fire. Pardon the cliche. They were up yesterday. They're up again today because if they... This is a theory at this point because it would still have to go through the legislative process. But if you have a national legalization of cannabis in the United States, then the Canadian producers would benefit from that. And thus we are seeing the sector smoking hot this morning. But otherwise, look, this has been a remarkable week. You know, we've never seen, I don't think, certainly not historically, where you'd see a market move as much as it has, considering we hadn't known where the market would go with the White House still too close to call. So, by the way, we've got a Friday feel good, not only Jaden, but here he is.
Finnegan, yes.
Yeah, stealing the show.
I've been smiling so big this whole business report. I know you talk about serious stuff all the time, but this is just such an adorable little family photo. Mike Eppel, his daughter Jaden on Take Your Kid to Work Day, and little Finnegan as well. Oh, giving kisses. So sweet.
There you go.
Have a nice weekend, the Eppel fam. Take care. We'll see you Monday, Mike.
See ya.
7:27 now on Breakfast Television. The U.S. election is still a close contest, but there is a new leader this morning in Pennsylvania and in Georgia. We'll have more on this coming up.